Our next speaker is a human-computer interaction student and user experience designer by day. And she's a plant lover by night, gardening in the dark. Please welcome Ruchi Ukalkar.
Hi, I'm Ruchi, and I'm going to show you how to design a voice interface in 5 easy steps. But first, let me tell you a story. So I was in my freshman year of college, and I decided to go to China for a month-long internship. So I did my paperwork, got my visa, learned some basic Chinese, and moved to China. When I was in China, I was meeting all these new people, and I wanted to be friends with them. So when I met this one girl, I looked at her and I said, "Mata Maya, how is your mother?" She gave me a weird look, because Ma in Chinese means horse, while Mama means mother. So this girl that I've met for the first time, I've essentially asked her, "How is your horse?" And this could have very easily been prevented if I had somebody to speak to in Chinese when I was practicing it. So when I came to grad school, I said, enough. I'm not going to ask people about their horses anymore. And I'm going to make sure nobody else ever does. So I designed Chatty, a voice interface that talks to you in the language you're learning. And I did this using 5 easy steps, which I'm going to share with you, so you know why Alexa says the things it does. Step number one is to find your problem. You want to look at where is the user struggling the most. You want to look at what are the gaps in the current user experience. For me, I needed somebody to speak to in Chinese, and that was the gap that I wanted to bridge. Having done this, you also want to think about, is voice the right modality for your solution? Can your problem be solved using an Instagram filter, using a website? Does it have to be voice? One way to know this is to think about the context of use. When and where is your user going to use your product? And why is he or she going to do that? For me, I needed somebody who I was going to talk to and somebody whose pronunciations I could listen to. So voice made perfect sense. Once you've identified your problem and convinced yourself why voice is the solution, you want to move on to the next step, which is to design a dialogue flow. What is a dialogue flow? A dialogue flow is essentially a decision tree, which has nodes and branches. The nodes are your decision points. And based on what your user says, you would then pick a particular branch. For example, if the Domino's app on Alexa says, "Would you like some extra cheese on your pizza?" Depending on if you said yes, the app is going to say, "Great, extra cheese is always good." Or if you said no, it's going to say, "Okay, what other toppings would you like?" You want to make this entire decision tree of your system to understand your information architecture. It's going to help you crystallize where your user is flowing and at what points does it need support. This brings me to my next point, which is to speak to your user. Humans are a really talkative species. However, we don't write the same way that we speak. So you want to go out there in the real world and examine how are people talking. You want to essentially look for 2 things. One, what is the content of their conversations? So what are they saying? What responses are they expecting? How are their conversations changing paths? And 2, what are their speech patterns? So do they pause after certain words? How long of a pause is too long? Are they using filler words? Doing this is going to give you a rich data set that you can use to design natural conversation, because you would know what this user is saying to your system, and you could then use the same words to respond back to the system such that it sounds natural. Which brings me to step number 4, which is error handling. 80% of designing for voice is designing for edge cases, or errors. What are errors, you ask? Errors are when you say something to Alexa, and Alexa does not understand what you're saying, right? So what you need to do as a conversation designer is accept that there was failure. Say, "I'm sorry, I cannot understand you right now." And then secondly, you want to offer an alternative. So you want to say, "I'm sorry, I cannot do this right now, but here's something else I can do. Will that help you?" Doing these 2 together is called graceful failure. And failing gracefully is the key to an excellent voice user interface. Which brings me to my final step, which is to test. So you've done all of this amazing work and you've designed your solution. You want to build it and take it back to the user. You want to take it back to the user and give them small tasks to do with your system to see whether your system can fulfill the needs it set out to. and you want to look at the breakpoints in your user journey. So what are the points where your system is failing the users? You want to go back to the designing board and iterate over your solution. And keep on iterating over your solution until you're happy with the desired results. So those are the five steps that a conversation designer uses to get Alexa to say the things she does, and that I use to making sure I never ask people about their horses anymore. Thank you.
Thanks, Rishi.